so you can see the texture in the background here. And what I do is I put my gesso on it, and I put a bit of my some of these mesh, and I put them down. So let me show you while I do one at least, so you can see how I create my some of my texture. So I'm just gonna put a piece right here. Brush it over with some of my where's my brush? I just had it in my hand. I lost it already. How you got that? Jeez, take me to the candy store. Oh, here we go. And I can't find a candy filter. So take the brush and hold this down a little bit and just go over the piece of mess that I put there. So this is a wood board. I'm kind of letting it dry a little before I store it on it, because it's too wet right now, and I'm afraid that the mesh will come off if it's wet. Yeah, so I'm trying to... It's a very tiny canvas. It's only 16 by 16, but I hope you can see the mesh in there. Up, I could use this thing that I bought. See, FW mixed media paint markers. You fill this in with fill it in with some golden, you know, the acrylic kind of fluid that is this is a fluorescent green, but it's like a fluid acrylic. You see. Acrylic, so you put it in here, and this you got to buy separate. It's a container where you put the paint in it, in there. Let's see, put the paint in there, put this in there, drop it back in there, turn this tight so it don't fall off or anything, and then you press on it. And you start, you know, writing. As soon as it goes all the way through, you gotta push down a couple of times till you get the paint. Let me push it down till the paint comes down. So, here. If I turn it around, there we go. See, it's the, like the Posca pens. You gotta push it until the paint comes down, and then you could paint with it. It's like a graffiti kind of thing, you know? But you could actually make all kinds of marks with it. But your paint has to be dry, so I don't want to mess this up by doing it when the paint is not dry, because if you do that, then you mess up your nice new equipment. So, yeah, so I'm going to have to wait to... Yeah, I'll wait till tomorrow, and this is all kind of, it's okay, I have another one at least, I have a new one that I could put on, so, yeah, so then you take and you make all kinds of designs with it, but once it gets completely full of the paint, let's see if I hit it a couple of times, more paint will come in it. To mess up this painting, but I can mess it up. So you work on it. So the color comes out, and then you see how you write with it. You press down and it writes. So it's great for making lines on your paint and stuff like that. So you see. Nice to have to play with. See, now I messed up this painting, but it's okay. I just wanted to show you how it worked. Let me not use it anymore on the paint, because then I'm gonna really mess it up. I'll put this away, and I'll talk to you guys tomorrow when I start doing my alcohol art. Or if I do this one first, I may do a abstract painting out of this one. Now that I messed it all up, abstract out of it. Which means, you know, I could just take colors and slap it on. Let's see if I have some colors here I can use. I got some red here. Get a bit of red. I gotta let the gesso dry. All right, guys. I see ya mañana. All right. Love you all. God bless. And thank you to all my subscribers, all my likes. I'm gonna be back on tomorrow to finish this one. This one's gonna be an abstract little painting. It's only 16 by 16. But it's a wood board, so I could always, at least get it resin after, so to make it nice and neat, to keep it nice and neat. All right, that is it, guys. Love you. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye. Just wanted to show you how I do some of my texture. Love you. Bye.